Ended garlic.
All right, moments ago, the president put off a new tweet saying what he thinks about the special counsel's investigation. This is the latest. A total witch hunt with massive conflicts of interest is what the president wrote. This, of course, follows Attorney General Jeff Sessions firing former Deputy FBI Director Andy McCabe. Joining me now, Josh Campbell, CNN law enforcement analyst and former FBI supervisory agent. Also, Asha Rangappa, CNN legal and national security analyst and former special agent in the FBI. Guys, there are three sort of separate but connected things here. Number one, you know, the firing of Andy McCabe, the determination by the Inspector General and the Office of Professional Conduct that he lacked candor in some of his answers. That's one. Number two is the timing. And number three is the issue of whether or not the president has been providing pressure here in this case. I know they're connected, but if we can break them down sort of one by one. Josh, first of all, you know, lacking candor inside the FBI, that is something that will get anyone fired, correct?
That's correct, John, and good to be with you and Asha. I'll start by saying that you're absolutely right, that lack of candor in the FBI is a serious offense, and it's something that every FBI employee from day one is drilled into them, that if you lack candor, which is your currency in this agency, and you're no longer of use to this organization, you're done. The organization is based on truth. But here's a problem here with the issue of Andy McCabe, and, you know, full disclosure, I briefly, you know, worked for Andy as his special assistant, so let me, you know, put that out on the table. I think there's been a tremendous disservice done to him here. We can hold in our heads two thoughts, the first of which being that it's possible that he lacked candor, in which case he should suffer the full consequences for that. But the second thing is that this service has been done not only to him, but to the American people, because essentially what the Attorney General is asking is, trust me, we're going to put out a press release, which is very, you know, lacking in detail, mainly focused on process, and saying, trust me, without providing the American people the underlying facts on which that decision was based.
And we do not know what's in the Inspector General report. We will presumably hear that at some point. And Asha, sort of the second last beat on this first issue is the Inspector General and the Office of Professional Conduct, insofar as anything can be apolitical here. These two organizations, groups within the Justice Department and the FBI, fairly apolitical. You're talking about the IG and the OPC, right?
Yes, that's their point of being there, is to be an independent and, you know, insulated oversight for the Department of Justice and the FBI. So, you know, these processes are there for a reason. It's a good thing. That is exactly why these tweets by the president weighing in on what he thinks should happen is so damaging to the credibility of the institutions as a whole, because then whatever they come out with is only seen in that context and not seen as something that has been done independently. And I think that's the problem here, John, or one of the problems, as you mentioned, with the timing and all of these other commentary that's been going on by someone who, by the way, is self-interested in the outcome here, because Andy McCabe is a witness against the president in his obstruction case.
So talk to me about the timing, Asha. Why does the timing seem funny to you?
Well, I have to see the OIG report, but, you know, depending on when this started, was this after the House Intelligence Committee testimony where Andrew McCabe revealed that he might have information against the president? You know, was there any pressure put on externally to launch this investigation? And also, was this speeded up in any way to give a decision before what would have normally occurred? I think what we want to know is, were there any departures from normal procedure for anybody else in the way that this was handled?
In the overall impact, Josh, when we're talking about the political pressure, I think you can go back to December and you can find a tweet from the president where he notes that Andy McCabe's got 90 days left before he collects a full pension. You know, clearly the president was weighing in on this whole process or from early on.
Right. And here's my concern here. I mean, if you look at what happens in politics, politics is all about trying to create a narrative and essentially, you know, prove to the American people that you are the one to be trusted, that they should focus on, you know, supporting you. And a large part of that is oftentimes discrediting your opponent, which is completely fair game in politics. We see it every day. I think the issue here is that in our system of justice, there cannot be doubt by the public on the rule of law in the United States. It's fairness, it's independence. So when you start using political tactics to go after law enforcement, I think it's a very dangerous road to start down.
The issue, though, is, you know, the president may be being political here, but we don't have any reason to think that the inspector general or the Office of Professional Conduct is being political, do we?
No, I don't think we do. But the problem is that we're essentially left to make these decisions in a vacuum. So without that full detail, we simply don't know. If you look at the IG investigation, some of the reports that have been done over the years, I mean, when they issue something, if there's a scathing report that faults an agency for something, at least you have the information and you can have an informed debate. We don't have that information. So this debate is anything but informed.
You know, and now we have this memo war, Asha, where Andy McCabe let it be known that he wrote contemporaneous memos of his meetings with the president. The president already trying to suggest that those memos shouldn't be trusted. This gets to the issue of credibility again. Who's credible here?
That's right. And I just want to say, from a legal perspective, there's something called present recollection recorded, which means that when you write something down at the time that it happens, if it becomes relevant later, that written recording carries great evidentiary weight because it's kind of presumed to be a truthful representation of what happened. So this is not great for the president. And I also want to point out that his tweets today concerning the conflict of interest actually goes to one of the grounds that the special counsel could be fired. So I think it's important to know that he's starting to use the language that is actually in the special counsel regulations that would give grounds for firing Mueller.
No, it's a very important point right there. He is using specific language that means something when you're talking about a special counsel. Whether he knows that or not, I guess we can't be sure, but you should give the benefit of the doubt, I suppose, to the president of the United States saying something specific. Josh Campbell, Asha Rangappa, thanks so much, guys, for being with us. Appreciate it.
Thanks.
Thank you.
All right. So is this the opening curtain?